This is Kurt Heisinger, accounting professor at Sierra College and author of Managerial Accounting. This video describes the nature of an operating budget and how operating budgets are used by organizations. So what is an operating budget? It's a plan of the resources that we need as an organization to achieve our goals. It's typically prepared in advance of the upcoming, say, month, quarter, or year. It's typically within a year. And it shows us what we need to do to achieve our goals. As shown here in the third bullet point, that we're trying to figure out what we need to do to achieve our goals. And the focus is on the daily operations of the organization. So typical for a manufacturing company, a typical set of operating budgets would include a sales budget, what we expect to sell in the upcoming period, and then the production costs. Again, if we're a manufacturing company, the production costs that we expect to incur for direct materials, direct labor, and manufacturing overhead. It would also include a selling and administrative budget. What kind of marketing costs, for example, do we expect to see in the upcoming period? It would also typically include a capital expenditures budget. Do we need to buy any new machinery, any long-term assets? That should be included in the capital expenditures budget. It would also typically include, probably most importantly, a cash budget. What do we expect our cash inflows to be and our cash outflows to be? And then ultimately, a budgeted income statement and a budgeted balance sheet. As I mentioned before, the budget operating budget is typically a short-term budget, meaning within 1 year. We're looking ahead 1 year. And it's used for planning and control purposes, meaning that the planning part of that is looking ahead, making sure we have enough in the way of direct labor, direct materials, and other resources to achieve our goals. And then it's for control purposes. So after the fact, we would take a look at whether we actually achieved the goals that we had set. So an example of this would be, maybe we just take it on a personal level. We have a budget of $400 for food for a given month, for this upcoming month. Well, we would establish that budget. We would plan. Hopefully, we would stay within that $400 budget. But to determine if we did or not, after the fact, after the month goes by, we would look back and see what were our actual expenditures for food and what was our budget and what's the difference between the two. That's the control phase. And then we would make some adjustments accordingly based on that information. Well, this same process takes place for organizations as well. They'll establish the budget in advance of the upcoming period, and then after the fact, look back and see how well they did comparing actual results to their budget.